Does baking soda really kill dust mites? In this article, we're going to talk about using the common leavening agent known as baking soda to kill dust mites. Before we get into the article, it's important that you understand the difference between baking soda and baking powder. Differences between baking soda and baking powder. While there are many similarities, considering they are both leavening agents, the two are vastly different. The difference comes mostly in their chemical components. Don't worry, we're not going to dive too deep into the actual chemical makeup of these two agents. We're just going to break it down simply. Baking soda is a base. It's meant to have a reaction with other chemical components. While it is used in baking to fluff up pastries and add depth, it can also leave a metallic aftertaste if not mixed correctly. Now, baking powder actually has baking soda in it. The baking soda helps to initiate the chemical reactions required. However, it's not the primary focus of baking powder, which is in baking. Often to rise dough, but leaving no metallic aftertaste. Alright, so it's pretty hard to give you a proper definition of either leavening agent. They are used similarly. But, the chemical reaction in baking soda is exactly why it's used for so many non-cooking solutions around the house. The uses of baking soda. Baking soda is often used in household cleaning solutions. We've used it to get stains out of the mattress, or clean up the rug after the dog had an accident. Baking soda is great at absorbing scent as well as cleaning surfaces. This mixture consists of adding a little water, then applying a paste to the affected areas. Interestingly enough, baking soda can also be thrown in with a load of laundry in place of a fabric softener. It can help thoroughly clean stained clothing, as well as take out smells that the washing machine just seems to keep looking over. How does baking soda work for pest control? The same chemical reaction we spoke of earlier is exactly what pests don't like. If baking soda can kill out the smell of your dog's gift to the carpet, you can imagine unwanted critters aren't enjoying it either. Baking soda has been a household trick, passed down from generation to generation, to eliminate all unwanted guests. With other pests, baking soda has proven to be an effective way of terminating them. For instance, if you have an ant infestation, the first advice you'll find is to sprinkle the entrances with baking soda. If you see any cracks or holes in your home, you can simply fill them with baking soda to prevent ants from coming in. This works with many other pests, too. Cockroaches aren't a fan of baking soda. The reason insects and pests don't like it is because of that same chemical reaction. Picture the vinegar baking soda explosion. Now, imagine that is happening inside of an ant, or cockroach, or even a dust mite. That is exactly what's happening. The acid that each living creature naturally has combines with baking soda. This creates the volcano effect, only internally. Which means you'll see a lot less of those annoying pests. Another reason baking soda is so useful is because it dries up moisture. Many pests enjoy moist and humid areas. Dust mites are no exception to that. Baking soda versus the dust mites. Method 1, sprinkle, wait, vacuum. All you have to do is sprinkle some baking soda on the areas that are contaminated. You'll want to leave it sit on the fabric for at least 15 minutes. This allows it time to really soak into the threading. After the time is up, you simply take a vacuum and let it absorb the baking soda, along with the dust mites, for sure. Obviously, your next step is getting the vacuum bag out of the house as quickly as possible. You don't want it sitting around the house, giving the dust mites the chance to climb right back out and head back to their favorite places in your home. Method 2, spray essential oils. Some people have said that method 1 doesn't work for them. Many others suggest combining baking soda with an essential oil does the trick much better. If you're more inclined to try the method with oils, we've got a few suggestions about what might work. For this method, you'll mix the essential oils with water and spray the mixture all over the affected areas. You can choose to focus on any one of the essential oils below, or you can put a drop or two of each of them into the mixture. This is done for maximum effect, of course. Clove, lavender, wintergreen, peppermint, eucalyptus, rosemary. Method 3, combination. Method 3 combines both of the above tactics. This method uses baking soda, essential oils and the vacuum cleaner to get the best possible results. For this method, you'll mix in about half of baking soda with a dozen drops of the essential oils. It's recommended that you use multiple oils, especially for this particular method. You'll mix the baking soda with the oils and put the mixture all over the areas in which you have dust mites. Now, for this particular method, you'll leave the mixture sit for up to an hour. This is called a deep clean and ensures that even the dust mites living deep in the threading are taken care of. After the hour, you'll get out that trusted vacuum cleaner and you'll suck up the little buggers. Again, get the vacuum bag out of the house quickly and efficiently. You can always try each method. What works for some won't work for others. You'll want to keep in mind that baking soda is abrasive. It can be damaging to delicate fabrics. But, the alternative is keeping these pests around, and that's not something you want. It's actually very unhealthy to share a living space with these dust mites, so kick them out.